going to be doing my summertime foundation routine. I don't really know what I'm calling it exactly yet, but this is like the most requested video on my channel right now. I was actually planning on filming something else before this, but I asked you guys on Twitter several days ago if you would like to see my current summer go-to foundation routine, however I worded it, and that was one of my most favorited tweets of all time. So I was like, okay, I will take that as a very strong yes and get to filming. So I actually filmed this exact video yesterday, and when I sat down last night to edit it, halfway through the video, all of a sudden, everything becomes very overexposed and completely out of focus. And I do not know why, but as I was editing it, I was like, aah! Like I was so frustrated. So I'm gonna film it again today and do it right, because I am not about to upload a video that's blurry for half the time. So if I seem to be doing this the entire time and looking at the viewfinder, it's because I'm going to try to make sure that that does not happen again. I don't know what the heck happened. It's been a very long week. I have missed you guys. It was my birthday week. I turned 26. It was such a weird birthday. It was just weird. Like, I'm so young. Like, 26 is still such a baby, but like, for some reason, this was the first birthday I've ever had that I was just like, not feeling it. I just think because I feel like birthdays are just happening so quick now, because the older you get, like, your perception of time, like, speeds up or something. I don't know. It's just weird. Okay, I'm gonna stop rambling. It's been too long and I'm gonna jump into the video now. Okay, so first thing I'm gonna do is prime my skin. I highly recommend priming your skin before you go in with foundation, which is crazy to even hear those words come out of my mouth, because up until just like a year or two ago, I wasn't even a believer in primers, but I feel like the priming world has stepped up their game. And my absolute favorite one is the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. I have bought this 3 times. This is my 3rd bottle. It has a beautiful luminosity to it. It feels like a lotion on your skin. It doesn't feel sticky or tacky or silicone-y. It doesn't feel like your skin can't breathe. It just feels like a regular moisturizer. It has a beautiful luminosity, and I feel like when I apply my foundation, it really like holds onto my foundation, and I think that it makes my foundation and my skin throughout the day just look very glowy without looking like greasy or too dewy. I'm just gonna take like a pump and a half on my fingertips. Make sure that your fingers are clean when you are applying primer, otherwise you can spread bacteria and cause breakouts, even though my hands are not clean right now. So for today's video, I'm going to be using the Josie Maran foundation. Oh my god, this foundation is incredible. Josie Maran came in out of nowhere and just like stole the foundation game, in my opinion. Every single person I have recommended this to is in love with it. It's so crazy to me. I don't know what this like voodoo black magic is. My friend Jackie and my friend Christian and my friend Marissa, they are all very oily, all different levels of oil, and they all love this foundation. I am very dry. I love this foundation. My mom has very mature skin. She loves this foundation. I've recommended this to my cousins, my friends, my family. Everyone loves it, no matter what skin type they have. It's strange because it's like has a very dewy finish, but yet it just like stays all day. And my friends who are oily, I can't speak for this, but my friends who are oily, they say that it keeps them looking dewy all day, but it doesn't let the oil break through so they don't get greasy looking. So I can't really speak for myself on that because I'm not oily, but that's what my oily friends say about this foundation. I'm going to be mixing the Cover FX Custom Enhancer Drops into my foundation today. Now you might be thinking that I'm totally crazy because I'm going to be mixing a very intense liquid highlighter into an already vibrant and like radiant foundation, but I love this combination so much. I've talked about these a couple times before. They are crazy pigmented. I've never seen anything like this. They're so innovative. They're so cool. They're like the most intense liquid highlight I've ever seen in my life. And this is actually my favorite way to wear them, is to mix them in with my foundation. I absolutely love the outcome. So I'm gonna do 2 pumps in the back of my hand, just like that. I don't even know if I'll use all that, honestly, because this foundation a little bit goes a very long way. And I am using the shade Moonlight in the Cover FX Drops. And I'm gonna do like a drop, and I wanna do like a drop and a half. There we go. I don't wanna do 2 drops, I feel like that could be too much. So just like a drop and a half, it looks like that on the back of my hand. And then I'm going to just mix that all together. All right, so now I'm just gonna take that on my finger. I'm just gonna dab it on my face, just make sure that it's not stuck in my nail or anything. I start off with a very small amount of foundation on my face. I always start like kind of towards the center of the cheek. I don't start on the edges because I can always add more. I don't like to take it and dot it all over my face because then it can become too much too quickly and it's kind of hard to eliminate. So I start off with a little bit and then I just continue to add and build up. So I'm gonna go in with the Morphe M439. This has been my favorite foundation brush for quite some time. It is a synthetic kabuki brush. It blends out everything so beautifully. There is the Sigma F80. That's a great one. That's also synthetic. That's a flat top. There is the Tarte Kabuki brush, which is like a big fat one. That one is really nice as well, but this is just always my go-to. There's something about it that I always go back to it. So just taking another stamp, I always kind of start in the center of the face and then work outward because I want the most coverage to be in the center of my face. So that's where I'm initially gonna put the product and then blend everything out from there. This foundation goes such a long way. I already have like this whole part of my face done and look at how much I still have. Like honestly, you only need one pump of this foundation to do your entire face. I'm gonna zoom you guys in a little bit. I'm scared to zoom you in a lot because this is when everything went out of focus yesterday and got blurry. So I'm really nervous. Ah, I'm gonna be looking in the viewfinder constantly. Okay, so now I'm going to move straight on to concealer and I'm gonna be using my favorite one. This is the Urban Decay Naked Weightless Concealer. I'm using the shade Medium Light Neutral. And what I'm gonna do is paint this under my eyes. I'm gonna start in the inner corner because my brush never gets this area in the inner corner with foundation. I'm gonna bring it down the sides of my nose. I'm gonna put it underneath my eye, all the way down here so I give this entire area coverage and it all looks even in one color. Now flipping it over and using the other side of the wand, I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm gonna do a little strip down the center of my nose, totally crooked, but whatever, blend that out. I'm gonna do a little cross right there. I'm gonna give my upper lip some coverage because my upper lip looks so bad right now, oh my gosh. And then I'm also going to put it over that little blemish that I have right there. As you can see, I did not use a concealer that's a lot lighter than my foundation. Maybe one shade lighter, if that. But I still wanted to put it under my eye and in the T-zone. That way everything looks way more even out and balanced once I blend all the concealer out into my foundation. I'm going to be using a damp beauty sponge. I cannot stress enough how much everybody needs a damp beauty sponge in their life. It is a game changer. This one is by Morphe. They sent it to me months ago straight from their lab because they know that I am like diehard for beauty sponges. I love the Beauty Blender, the Real Techniques sponge. So they sent this to me and asked me if I liked it. And I told them, yes, I loved it. And it's the only one that I've been using ever since. This one is pink. The ones that they sell on the website are red, but they're the exact same ones. And I have to say, it's my favorite damp sponge so far. So I'm just gonna be pressing into the skin. As you see, I am not going to be rubbing. I am pouncing and pressing into the skin using a decent amount of pressure. And not only will this press the foundation into the skin, but pressing it in like this will also pick up any excess product that would be sitting on the skin if you were to use a brush. So you won't get cake face throughout the day and you won't have buildup. Make sure on your under eye area, you go back and forth. If you just go one way over and over and over, it can actually do the opposite of what you're trying to do and make your concealer crease into your fine lines. This is like the best foundation tip in the entire world. If you're looking to take your foundation to the next level, applying it with a synthetic brush, but then going over everything with a damp blender is just like, I swear, the most beautiful outcome that you can ever get. Now the very next thing I'm going to do is set my under eye area. I have a couple of different methods that I use to set my under eye. Sometimes I will use a translucent powder. Any translucent powder that you have that you love will work, and I use a damp blender to apply that. But recently, especially for summertime, I have been using my go-to products, which are MAC Pro Emphasize. You can get this on maccosmetics.com. It is like a shaping powder. You can use it on the under eye or anywhere on the face, of course. And it's not a matte powder, but it's not a shimmery powder. It's got like a satin kind of glow to it. And then this one right here is the Anastasia Banana Powder that is sold in her contour kit and also individually, I think, on Sephora website. So I'm gonna be using the Morphe E49. This is from their new Elite collection. And I'm gonna be using both of those products back and forth, like an even amount of them. And I'm going to press this into my under eye. And I make sure that I literally press it into the skin. No rubbing allowed. Because by pressing it, I am ensuring that I'm not going to remove any of the concealer that I've already applied. I'm not going to move anything around. I'm just going to set what I have done. I'm also gonna do the same thing on my eyelids because I do not want my eyelids to crease because that's just like inevitable. Okay, so now for the next step, I'm going to set my entire face with powder. And if you guys have been here on my channel for a while, then you would know that I am crazy picky about powder. And up until recently, I haven't even really set my face with powder on a daily basis. I'll kind of go back and forth, but because I am dry, most powders tend to make me just look kind of like chalky or just like dusty. And throughout the day, it just kind of gets like I don't know, just, it just doesn't look good. It just looks kind of crepey and it's just not flattering on my dry skin. But I have been absolutely in love with this, especially for the summertime. I don't know when winter comes along if I'm gonna keep using this, we'll see. But especially for summer, just wanting like that radiant glow, I cannot get enough. I raved about this in my favorites video if you wanna see me talk more about it there. But this is by Lancome and it is the shade Absolute Golden, and this is the Absolue powder. It has like luminosity in it, which is kind of a strange idea to take like a luminous powder and put it all over my entire face, but I just love the way it looks. I mean, I just played with it one day when I was sitting at my vanity and I wasn't going anywhere. She's like, oh, what's the worst that can happen? I look like a disco ball, who cares? I'll wash it off, it's just makeup. But I absolutely ended up loving it, and so now I use it all the time. So I'm going to be using the Morphe E41 brush to apply this. As you can see, I have a very small amount on it. I do not pack my brush full of it, otherwise I will look like a disco ball. It's just a really small amount, and I always start at the bottom of my face. I recommend using a very big powder brush for this, like the bigger the better, because you're not gonna wanna use something like small and dense because it'll pack on way too much, and then you'll have like boom, shimmer on your face. So something really big and just a light application. So I'm gonna put this on the entire outer perimeter of my face. The only area that I'm gonna kind of avoid is this area right here where I already set my under eye. And the reason why I avoid that is because recently I've had a lot of texture right here. I don't know why. I don't know what's happening. I need to go get like my face looked at and get a facial. But this entire area, I've had some very strange texture, and I don't want to put this powder there because the more powder that you put on and the more shimmer and glowy products you put on, the more attention it's going to bring to texture. So since I already set my under eye area with a light highlighting powder, I don't want any more, otherwise it'll make my texture stand out. So I'm going to avoid that area, but everything else I'm going to cover in this powder. And each time I dip it in, I make sure that I don't have too much on the brush. All right, so now I'm gonna go back in with these two highlighting powders right here. This is just like so unappealing. Like, this looks so messy, just gross, but whatever, it's reality. And I'm gonna go in with the exact same brush that I used to set my under eye area, and I'm gonna put those products on my chin, my upper lip, and the center of my forehead. So my T-zone area, just to bring a little bit of a highlighted effect there over top of the powder that we just applied to kind of match the under eye area. I'm going to be using the Makeup Forever bronzer in the shade 25i or 25-1, one of my favorite bronzer formulas ever. It looks like this, and it is waterproof. I didn't even realize it was waterproof, but it is. And to apply that, I'm going to be using this brush by Morphe. This is the E2. I talked about this in my favorites video as well. I absolutely love this brush for bronzer. So I'm just gonna apply this to the entire outer perimeter of my face, starting on the cheek area. I want everything to be the darkest back towards the hairline. I never apply bronzer in the center of my face, like on my nose and on my cheeks. If you do that and you feel like it looks good, that's awesome, more power to you. I definitely look very splotchy and blotchy and not cute when I do that. So I kind of just stick to the outer perimeter of the face. I'm just gonna go ahead and apply some blush and highlight. These are the Becca Cosmetics Split Pans featuring my baby, Champagne Pop. And then this one is their Mineral Blush Flower Child right here. And I'm going to apply Flower Child on the apples of my cheeks. I don't want it to be too intense though. Yes, honey. All right, and then I'm going to highlight using Champagne Pop, and I am using a fan brush by Morphe. This is the M310. Oh, hello, lover. I'm gonna highlight the tip of my nose. I don't know why I'm even doing this. I don't even like the way it looks when I highlight my nose, but everyone does it, so I feel the pressure. I'm just gonna run over my cheeks with my blush brush just so that it's not like so highlighting that it blinds you. Let me just go ahead and finish off like my eyebrows and like fix these crusty lips real quick, and I'll be right back. So I was gonna do my hair for you because I thought like this is just unacceptable, but my sister is at the pool right now and she's texting me to come to the pool with her. It's a Saturday afternoon, so I'm like, why am I about to do my hair and make it look pretty when I'm gonna go sweat my balls off at the pool? The pool is not a pleasant experience here in Florida, in case you were wondering. It's kind of miserable. I don't know even why we go to the pool in the summertime, because you're just like, it's not a good look for anybody. Anyway, so that completes this video, you guys. I really hope that you enjoy. I had fun making this. I hope that it was as good as yesterday's video because I feel like I'm always better filming something like the first time around. And since I had to refilm this, I hope that it still, you know, is like a good video for you. Anyways, the one tip that I want to leave with you before ending this video is for absolutely everybody. The most universal tip, no matter if you are dry, oily combination, no matter if you have mature skin, whoever you may be out there, the one tip that I would recommend to everybody is to apply your foundation with a synthetic haired brush. Whatever brush that may be, it doesn't matter, a synthetic haired brush, blending it out, working in circular motions, and then pressing it into the skin with a damp beauty sponge. I know it seems a little high maintenance, but this is what I picked up along the way. These two together, there's something about blending out liquid foundation with a synthetic haired brush and then pressing it into the skin with a damp beauty sponge. Oh my gosh, I don't know what it is, but I just find that it gives the most airbrushed, flawless finish to the foundation. So that's it, you guys. I really hope that you enjoy this video. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys, and I will see you in a couple of days. Bye.